Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss problems in exercise 11.2, that is question from 8 to 10. So, now we will discuss question number 8, that is PQRS and ABRS are parallelograms. PQRS and ABRS are two parallelograms given in this figure and x is any point on the side BR. Okay, here x is any point on the side BR. Now we have to show that area of PQRS parallelogram and area of ABRS parallelogram equal and area of triangle AXS, area of triangle AXS is equal to half of the area of parallelogram PQRS. We have to show. See, how it is very simple. We are familiar with the concept related to this problem. Already we have discussed in the previous session. That is, so if two parallelograms on same base and between same parallel lines, so they are equal in their area. Is it? And also one more concept, another statement is area of a triangle is equal to half of the area of a parallelogram, where this triangle and the parallelogram are same side and between same parallel lines. Is it? So based on that concept, we are going to prove whatever we required from this problem. Okay, in this problem. So let us see the solution. Regarding first one, we have to show that the area of PQRS is equal to area of ABRS. Okay. To show it, what are we doing? See, simple. If you observe here, PQRS parallelogram and ABRS parallelogram, these two parallelograms are on the same base SR. Am I correct? On the same base SR. On the same base SR. And between two parallel lines, PB and SR. Is it? So, here, parallelogram PQRS and the parallelogram ABRS on same base. Both are on same base. What is that base? SR. And between same parallel lines. What are those parallel lines? And between same parallel lines. What are those parallel lines? That is PB and SR. PB and SR. So we know that their areas are equal. Therefore, area of parallelogram PQRS is equal to area of parallelogram PQRS is equal to area of parallelogram ABRS. Since both are on same base SR and between same parallels, PB and SR. Okay, clear. So, area of ABRS. So, first one proved by it. Now, to prove second one, come to the point. Second one. Here, AXS and PQRS, the relation they asked. The relation between areas of triangle AXS and PQRS. Is there any link to prove it? No. Because here AX is a triangle on the base AS. But PQRS is a triangle on base RS. So no same base. Okay. So that to prove the area of triangle AX is equal to half of the area of triangle parallelogram PQRS, it is enough to prove area of triangle AX is equal to half of the area of parallelogram ABRS. Since in first one we proved that area of PQRS and area of ABRS are equal. So, to prove second one, it is enough to compare triangle AXS, okay, and parallelogram ABRS. Is it? Yes. So, now, to show second one, that is area of triangle AXS is equal to half of the parallelogram PQRS. To show it, now I am considering triangle AXS and parallelogram ABRS. Okay, here triangle AXS and parallelogram ABRS and parallelogram ABRS on same base. What is that base? Can you guess? Yes, AXS. For this base, if we consider AS, for ABRS also consider same base AS. Okay, so common side, we have to select a common side as base. Here common side for both triangle and parallelogram ABRS is AS. So same base AS, and between two parallel lines, what are those parallel lines? Now here AS and BR are the parallel lines. See, AS and BR are the parallel lines, is it? So both are on same base AS and between parallel lines, between same parallel lines, between same parallels. What are those parallels here? Between same parallel, that is AS and BR. AS and BR. So we are already familiar with the statement, that is, therefore we can write here area of triangle AX is equal to, area of triangle AX is equal to half of the area of parallelogram ABRS. Okay, ABRS. But in first one, the area of parallelogram ABRS is equal to area of PQRS are not. So from first one, what can I write here? Half into area of, in the place of ABRS parallelogram, I am writing area of PQRS. So it is second one. So finally we got the result of second result, that is area of triangle AX is equal to half of the area of parallelogram PQRS. Hence shown, it is second one. So very easy, very simple. Just we have to recall those concepts what we learned in the previous sessions. That is, parallelograms on same base and between same parallel lines are equal in area, and a triangle and a parallelogram on same base and between same parallel lines, then the area of a triangle is equal to half of the area of a parallelogram. Okay, so it is very easy, and based on this concept we are going to solve next two problems. Those are also very easy and very interesting, because those are related to real life situations. Okay students, now we discuss question number 9, that is C. It is a big question, but solution is very easy. Okay, so let me read. A farmer has a field in the form of a parallelogram PQRS as shown in the figure. So here a field is in the shape of a parallelogram. Okay, so it is a name of this field is PQRS. So it is in the shape of parallelogram as shown in this figure, and it took the midpoint A on RS, and it took a midpoint A on RS and joined it two points P and Q. They have joined like this, P and Q. Okay, in how many parts the field is divided? Now how many parts the field has divided? So 1, 2, 3 parts the field has divided into, 3 parts. Okay, how many parts? 3 parts. Okay, next question, what are the shapes of these parts? What are the shapes of these parts? These parts are, see, triangle APS, triangle ARQ and APQ, these are triangles. So what are the shapes of these parts? Mr., those are triangles. What are those parts? Triangle APS, triangle ARQ or AQR, or triangle APQ. And now the farmer wants to sow ground nuts which are equal to the sum of pulses and paddy. The farmer wants to sow ground nuts which are equal to sum of pulses and paddy. How should he sow? state reasons. So he wants to show groundnuts in this field such that the must be equal to sum of the pulses and the paddy. Okay. So in which area he has to show groundnuts and in which area he has to show either pulses or paddy. Like, so we have to find out. Then how to find it? Very simple. Here again same concept you have to use in this problem also. That is, here if you observe clearly this figure, here triangle APQ, here triangle APQ, the base is PQ and parallelogram PQR is also having same base PQ, and these triangle and parallelogram PQR is both are on same base and between two parallel lines, same parallel lines are on. Yes. So what can we write from this? We can write that, yeah, since triangle APQ and parallelogram PQRS on same base. What is the name of the base? PQ. And between same parallels. And between same parallels. What are those parallels? Yeah. RS and PQ. So from this what can I write? Yeah, I can write here clearly. Area of triangle APQ is equal to half of the area of parallelogram PQRS. Half of the area of parallelogram PQRS. Am I correct or not? Yes. He wants to show groundnuts in some region among these three parts, any one region, such that the other two regions also he wants to show with the pulses and the paddy. So the area showed by groundnuts is equal to the area showed by pulses and the paddy. So that statement should satisfy. So to that, what are the fields or what are the regions he is going to select and how to find out? So for that, what I am going to do now, I am subtracting this equation from full parallelogram, okay, from whole field. See, I am writing the statement, see, as like this. Parallelogram PQRS or quadrilateral PQRS minus triangle APQ. Triangle APQ. Okay, is equal to this side also. Parallelogram PQRS minus, what is the right side? Half of parallelogram PQRS. Okay, parallelogram PQRS. Okay, clear now? From full parallelogram PQRS, I am subtracting triangle APQ. I am subtracting triangle APQ. So, what is the remaining part? From full of this field, I am subtracting this triangle APQ part. And what is the remaining? That is APS and AQR is remaining. What is remaining? Triangle APS plus triangle AQR is remaining. Am I correct or not? From this parallelogram, I have subtracted the region APQ. Then the remaining parts are these two. Okay. And from full parallelogram PQRS, if you remove half of the parallelogram, then it will be half itself. Yes, half of the parallelogram PQRS. Okay. Now, if you compare these two again, one and this, if you consider a second equation, one and two, what can I write here? So, I can write that area of triangle APQ is equal to area of triangle APS plus area of triangle AQR. Am I correct or not? So from 1 and 2 we can conclude like this. Is it? Now see from this result, what do you understand? See from this result, so the area in this part, that means area of triangle APQ is equal to sum of the areas of these two triangles. Is it? Dear students, by this can you guess what is the region the farmer saw these groundnuts pad and pulses? Yeah, it is easy because the area of triangle APQ is equal to sum of the areas of these two triangles. Na? So easily we can say that now the farmer may sow groundnuts in on triangle APQ region, and the farmer may sow pulses on triangle ASP region, and the farmer may sow paddy on triangle AQR region. Of course, but he may change paddy or pulses on either this side or that side region because of fixed is groundnuts will be in this region. Groundnuts is sold in this region because according to condition, how much area is sowing the groundnuts in that must be equal to sum of pulses and paddy. So that this region should be sold by groundnuts itself. But this one either pulses or paddy, or paddy or pulses. Paddy or pulses. Okay. If we saw here pulses in this region, paddy. If we saw here paddy, he has to sow here pulses. That's it. But finally, the area which is sowed by groundnuts must be equal to sum of the areas or regions of these two. Okay. So clearly we can divide the whole field into this type. Okay, clear? Yeah. Okay, students. Now let us discuss question number 10. That is, prove that area of your rhombus is equal to half of the product of the diagonals. Half of the product of the diagonals. Now let us consider this is a ABCD rhombus. Okay, let us consider this ABCD is a rhombus. Okay. It is a rhombus. In this, what are the diagonals? AC and BD are the two diagonals. AC and BD are the two diagonals intersecting each other at O. Intersecting each other at O. We know that in a rhombus, diagonals bisect each other at right angle. Is it there? And here, AC and BD are diagonals. Okay. And also we know that AC is perpendicular to BD. AC is perpendicular to BD. Now consider the length of AC as a D1 units and the length of diagonal BD D2 units. Okay, D1 and D2. And we know that diagonals basically is a right angle, so that OA is equal to OC and OD is equal to OB. OD is equal to OB. Now required is you have to find the area of rhombus ABCD. To find the area of rhombus ABCD, I think it is enough to find the area of triangle ABC and ADC. Is it? Because if you find the areas of the triangle ABC and ADC respectively, and if we sum up these two areas, we can get area of rhombus ABCD. Is it? So that now I am trying to find the area of triangle ABC and triangle ADC. As we know that the area of a triangle formula is half base into height, and it is easy for us to find since see here in triangle ABC, if you consider base AC, then height will be OB. But what is the value of OB here? Half of D2. Reason is here these two are equal, na? So half D2, and in this case OD is equal to half D2. Since diagonal AC divides this diagonal BD into two equal halves, this total length is D2. So that OB is equal to OD is equal to half of BD. Covered half of DD, D2. Okay, D2. Now I am trying to find the triangle area of triangle ABC, that is equal to formula is half base into height. Half base into height. Here base is AC base is AC and height is OB. Okay, because it is perpendicular, diagonal bisect each other perpendicular. So the height OB. So that is equal to half AC value D1 into OB value of D2. And if we simplify, we will get 1 by 4 D1 D2. 1 by 4 D1 D2. This is the area of triangle ABC, 1 by 4 D1 D2. Now, find the area of triangle ADC. Okay. Here, area of triangle ABC is equal to 1 by 4 D1 D2. Now, area of triangle ADC. Very simple. Area of triangle ADC is equal to, again, same formula, half base into height. Here, again, consider base AC and height OD. That means half AC into OD. Half. But what is AC value? D1. And OD is equal again half of the diagonal BD. So half D2. So finally we get 1 by 4 D1 D2. So in the case of triangle ADC also we got same area, that is 1 by 4 D1 D2. Now to get the area of rhombus ABCD, we have to add the areas of these two triangles. What are those two triangles? Triangle ABC and triangle ADC. Okay. Therefore, area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ADC is equal to, add these two triangles. Add the areas of these two triangles, then we get 1 by 4 D1 D2 plus 1 by 4 D1 D2. If you add these two, we get here 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, half D1 D2. And sum of these two areas of triangles gives us area of rhombus ABCD, full figure, okay. Therefore, area of rhombus ABCD is equal to half D1, D2. Just you have considered a rhombus ABCD and we found. So, from this what can you say in words regarding this equation? You can say that area of a rhombus is equal to 1 by 2 is half of the D1 D2 means D1 into D2, product of the diagonals, half of the product of the diagonals. Okay. So, this is about the solution of question number 10. So, by this, all the solutions of this exercise completed. I hope you are all clear about these solutions. If you have any doubts, I am giving my number in the description. You can contact or you can send a WhatsApp message. I will clarify your doubts. You are always welcome. So, I hope you are all subscribed to my channel. If you do not subscribe, please subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification when I upload the videos. And I am very thankful to you everyone for your great support. We will meet in the next session with other concept. Till then, bye bye.